Hi, I'm Thom. As an avid and active software developer in the open source world, I am quite familiar with managing change. One of the most popular tools used in open source software for managing change is Git. It is freely available and it is quite popular. I would like very much to share with you some of the details that I understand about Git and why it may be valuable for you.
In this video, we will take a journey together, exploring software version control, what it is, the problems version control is designed to solve, an introduction to Git, a freely available version control system, an overview of Git and how it can help you, even if you are not a software developer. We have all struggled with the task of keeping track of changes. Have you ever found yourself saving multiple copies of your work under slightly different file names in order to not lose any of your previous efforts? This is not a very efficient way to manage change. If you have ever tried to locate that particular file that has that one and only change you made sometime last week in the afternoon on Tuesday, I think, then you understand the problem. When a software project has a team of people working on it, a file or set of files is quite often edited almost simultaneously by multiple people. The proper merging of multiple changes to the same file is a difficult and sometimes delicate process in itself. This is an even bigger problem. So it just makes sense to rely on a software tool to handle this for us. In order to facilitate the dynamic and constantly changing nature of software development, coders use some sort of version control system, or VCS, of which Git is an extremely popular one. Version control systems represent the concept of taking a step back in time, returning to a previous state. The premise of source control, as it's often called, is to capture the state of an entire set of files as an atomic unit. Not only does the tool handle most of the details of merging multiple changes, a version control system can offer a clear historical record of the project, and it provides the opportunity to step back in time, exploring all changes and updates, see who did what and when, and even selectively reproduce the state of the system at any point in the past. This is so crucial to software development that it influences the very workflow patterns developers use. But if you are not a software developer, why should you care? I propose that regardless of what you do with a computer, you are creating content that has value to you, and you likely follow an evolutionary process where things change over time. The ability to take a step back for reference or resurrection of your previous work must be an appealing idea. So, why is Git better or worse than any other source control? How is Git different? That is a fair question. And like so many facets of any creative process, like software development, the choice of tools can be quite a personal one and open to much debate. I have used many VCSs in my career, and here is my list of reasons I prefer Git. Open source means there are many eyes and hands on it. It also means anyone who has an idea to make it better or fix a problem can simply jump in and help. Free and open source usually go hand in hand, but not necessarily. But with Git, it is absolutely free and available in any platform. You no longer need to be a Linux geek super hacker in order to take advantage of Git. It can be installed and operated on Linux, Windows, Mac, and even remotely with services like Nitrous. Like all version control systems, Git can be thought of as a database of changes. Designed by Linus Torvalds, the creator of Linux, the fundamental architecture of Git favors speed and efficiency. Locating who applied a change, determining what was changed, and making a detailed comparison of the differences has all been carefully built in as primary operations. There are numerous hooks that can be utilized to trigger associated software routines, automating many tedious tasks associated with source control. Although these were built for the software development world, they are really just connection points to trigger other software to automate tasks. The distributed nature of Git makes it very easy for multiple people to actively contribute to a single project. This is the heart and soul of open source software development. Creating patches and updates was built right into the architecture. The fact that Git is distributed makes it extremely flexible. The heart of Git's distinctive architecture is the fact that everyone has a complete history locally. We will discuss branching in more detail in a moment. It is another differentiating architecture feature of Git. Admittedly, the command line is a bit arcane and the Git commands are difficult to learn. That is its heritage. However, there are many GUI tools and you can be successful with Git without getting your hands too dirty. Since Git is file-based, you can share and/or archive your repository in many convenient ways, including services like GitHub or Bitbucket, but also file-sharing services like Dropbox, Google Drive, OneDrive. I created a video about using Dropbox several years ago. One key requirement of version control is the ability to merge the work of several people on the same file or set of files. Imagine your regular workflow. As I mentioned earlier, you are most assuredly creating something on the computer. If you group your changes in a logical manner, for example, all changes to the About Us page, the existing state in time can be preserved with what is called a commit to source control. Think of it as a snapshot of the project at that moment. In reality, you have a lot of control over the details of a commit, but that comes from a little more experience. Imagine that you took a snapshot, a commit, of your work, and a colleague, or two or more, also made a commit of their work. In a simple example, you both touched a completely different file, so there is no real timeline. All changes occurred more or less simultaneously, but in parallel. Now, let's say you and your comrade made different changes to the same file. You, for example, changed the title, and he changed some of the content in the footer. It was the very same file. This is known as a conflict because there are two differing ideas of the proper state of the file. Identifying these conflicts, flagging them, and providing tools to resolve them simply is pivotal to a good version control system. Git handles this quite gracefully. Moreover, with a lineage called the history, you can determine what was changed and when and by whom at any time in the future. If necessary, any previous state can be restored in part or in its entirety. Are you beginning to imagine ways in which this capability can aid you in your regular work? You most certainly should be. As I mentioned, when a conflict is detected, the software, Git, defers to the all-knowing and mighty human being to resolve it. That is what software as a tool should do for us. But beyond that, there are times you may just want to experiment. And in particular, you do not want to interfere with the main work at hand of the efforts of your colleagues. This is a time to create a branch, which is simply a detour along the path of making changes. Branches are lightweight and free, you will hear Gitsperts exclaim. That is true, and one of the major differentiating factors of Git over its close cousins like Subversion. When working on a branch, which is still maintained in the history, you have the opportunity to merge back into the main trunk at any time. GitHub, a topic for detailed discussion in another installment, offers a great workflow for submitting a branch to open source software projects. I encourage you to jump right in and start using Git. There are numerous resources available to explain the details of using Git. Books, ebooks, blog posts abound on the web with lots of explanations and examples, mostly on the command line, but in abundance. I authored an introductory mini book you can find right here on Learnable. Lastly, experience with Git is a good thing to add to your resume. If you are a software developer, it is probably expected, like regular expressions. But regardless of your area of expertise, practice with the concept and mechanics of source control can be applied to any job, particularly since our entire world seems to rely on computers and computer software in some form or another. Please provide your ideas, thoughts, and comments. Oh, and yes, I did manage the creation of this video using Git. Thank you very much for watching.